Hi there, welcome back. In this lesson, we will learn about why quantum cryptography using quantum key distribution QKD protocol and then QKD process, and then we will end the lesson with benefits and drawbacks of quantum cryptography. Let's start with the purpose of using quantum cryptography. It's to create an encryption system that is virtually unbreakable, enabling the transmission of secure messages that are almost impossible to hack. In order to do that, it utilizes the laws and principles of quantum mechanics and the properties of photons. So, we mainly use quantum cryptography to protect the security of data transmitted over the fiber optic cables. If you look at the diagram on the right here, photons can oscillate in various directions such as vertical, horizontal, diagonal and anti-diagonal across the optical network. The next question is, how do we use quantum cryptography to send an encryption key from, let's say, Alice to Bob using the quantum key distribution QKD protocol? Take note that we are not sending plain text or messages this time around. We are actually sending the encryption key, so make sure you remember this. And then once both parties, who are Alice and Bob, have securely received the key through QKD, they can then use it for encrypting and decrypting messages. This part is similar to traditional symmetric key encryption. In general, before starting the QKD process, Alice and Bob will agree on how to interpret the polarization states in terms of binary values for each basis, which include Y basis and X basis. So for example, they can agree that in Y basis, vertical polarization is equal to bit 1, whereas horizontal polarization is equal to bit 0. Definitely, they can also agree the other way around, whereby vertical is bit 0 and then horizontal is bit 1. Next, for X basis, they set diagonal as bit 1 and then anti-diagonal as bit 0. After agreeing on the interpretation of polarization states, let's look at the actual QKD process step by step. Step 1 is Alice will generate 4 photons using a light source, and then each photon is in an initial undefined quantum state. Definitely, Alice can generate more than 4 photons. We are just using 4 photons for this demo to make it simple and easy to understand. Next, Alice polarizes each of the 4 photons in one of the 4 possible states, resulting in specific polarizations. So for example, horizontal for Y basis, diagonal for X basis, vertical for Y basis, and then anti-diagonal for X basis. These polarized photons will travel along a fiber optic cable to Bob. At the destination, Bob randomly chooses a beam splitter, either a vertical or horizontal splitter, which is a Y splitter, or a diagonal splitter, which is a X splitter, to measure each photon. For example, Bob chooses YYXX splitter to measure the 4 photons. Take note that Bob doesn't know the state of each photon beforehand. He just randomly chooses the splitter. Now, Alice and Bob then share their basis choices, which are YXYX from Alice compared to YYXX from Bob. After that, they identify matches and mismatches. For example, photon 1 match with YY, and then photon 4 match with XX. Mismatches like photon 2 and photon 3 will then be discarded. From the matched photons, Bob deduces the key based on his previous measurement from the splitter. So for example, photon 1, we will get horizontal, and based on the previous agreement, horizontal is equal to bit 0. And then for photon 4, we will get anti-diagonal, which is bit 0 as well based on the previous agreement. So, the final key would be 00. And finally, Alice and Bob will use the key for both encrypting and decrypting messages, ensuring secure communication. Let's talk a bit about the security aspect of quantum cryptography. If an eavesdropper attempts to intercept the key, the increased number of mismatches can alert both Alice and Bob to potential interception. ensuring the security of their communication. For example, if Alice sends 4 photons and Bob records all 4 as mismatches, it strongly indicates interference, as the probability of such a complete mismatch occurring naturally is extremely low. Now, let's talk about benefits of quantum cryptography. First of all, it provides security based on laws of physics rather than mathematical algorithms, so it's more secure and is virtually unhackable. So, as mentioned in the previous slide, any eavesdropping can be identified as the state will be changed. Furthermore, longer or more secure keys can be exchanged. At the same time, the performance of quantum cryptography is continuously improved, making it suitable for most valuable government or industrial secrets. For drawbacks of quantum cryptography, it lacks many vital features such as digital signature, certified mail, and etc. It currently only works over relatively short distances, so it has limited range. It requires dedicated fiber optic line and specialist hardware. And the cost of dedicated fiber optic line and specialist hardware is expensive. Sometimes, polarization of light may be altered while traveling down fiber optic cable. It also allows criminals and terrorists to hide their communications. And lastly, error rates are relatively high as technology is still being developed.